politics over the Maharashtra Haftagate scandal there continues. BJP leaders are now currently meeting with the Maharashtra governor over Parambir Singh's extortion charges against the state home minister Anil Deshmukh and his links with arrested cop Sachin Waze. BJP accuses Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray of deliberately hushing up Deshmukh's extortion bid and the nexus with cops. BJP has also slammed the Chief Minister, accusing him of sitting on the cash for transfer scam in the police department. Just yesterday, Deshmukh met with the Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray for the first time after being accused in the extortion racket. Inside sources suggest that the meet was over shunted intelligence chief Rashmi Shukla's report. The report, which was junked by the state government, claimed brokers and several top police officers there were involved in the transfer racket. Now let me take you through all those details that's been put up by Rashmi Shukla in that letter to Maharashtra DGP on the 25th of August 2020. Several charges that she's made, let me cut across. Here, the first charge that Rashmi Shukla makes is that brokers were involved in cops postings. Money was given in exchange for positions. That's what she says. She in fact says that she tapped phones of those few involved in dubious activity. Now, this, of course, came as a surprise for the Maharashtra government, saying that she tapped phones illegally. But here is Rashmi Shukla, who very well investigated into the matter and said that some of the phones were also tapped to get evidence of this. Now, she also makes a charge that inspectors, two IPS level officers, all of them were involved. Top to bottom, bottom to top, many of the IPS level officers and lower level officers were involved in this scam of cash for transfer and posting. Mustafa Sheikh joining us live for more details from Mumbai. Mustafa, Rashmi Shukla's report is indeed startling and cries of corruption within the police department in Maharashtra. She brought out this report. It had to be investigated, but instead of actually looking into the details of it, here is Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh, who shunned her away and allegedly gave those people postings who were mentioned in that report as corrupt. Now, of course, Maharashtra government denying these charges, saying that Rashmi Shukla could be a stooge of the BJP. We're looking at the BJP delegation now meeting with the governor. What's really transpired in that meeting?
Well, the BJP leaders are briefing the governor about the state of affairs which are ongoing in the state government, and there are many such things which are happening which raises suspicions on the fair running of the state government of Maharashtra. First, being an API, serving API, being arrested on the charges of planting explosive, and then for murder, then the CP had to be transferred because of the same incident, the CP making allegation that there is corruption happening, then there are reports by the BJP of state intelligence saying that money was taken for transfer. So all these things are being briefed out to the governor about the state of affairs of what is happening. It would be interesting to see what the central agencies are taking away on this on this entire case, because only they can investigate the allegations which are being made, and that would be a trouble for the state government, because the BJP is not having much faith in the state government's investigation regarding all these cases. Anil Deshmukh, for example, is still the home minister, has not resigned as per the demands of the BJP. So we'll have to wait and watch if government has some powers to take some move which can
to see if at all Maharashtra government their response to all those allegations, and if they will ask and pressurize Anil Deshmukh to actually resign. Now, Supreme Court will be hearing a plea today by the former Mumbai Police Commissioner Parambir Singh. The shunted top cop of Mumbai has now moved the top court, seeking probe into extortion charges that he has made against the Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh. Parambir Singh has now demanded a CBI probe into alleged malpractices against the under fire Home Minister. He's also sought probe into CCTV footage of Deshmukh's residence. He's also sought an investigation into the alleged irregularities in transfers and postings. In an explosive letter to Maharashtra Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray, Parambir Singh on Saturday alleged that Deshmukh asked Waze to collect 100 crore rupees every month. Parambir claimed that he had informed Uddhav Thackeray much earlier in March about the misdeeds of Deshmukh. A series of concerns that top cop Parambir Singh has raised in his plea, and these are the concerns. Plea number one, stay on transfer from Mumbai top cop post. This is what he's asked in his plea to the Supreme Court. He's gone on to further ask for a CBI probe against Deshmukh. In fact, Parambir Singh has also asked for probing the allegations of malpractice against Anil Deshmukh. All those allegations that he's made, he's asked for all of that to be probed. In fact, here, Parambir Singh is also pushing for the CCTV footage of Anil Deshmukh's home to be investigated. And then, furthermore, the plea also pushes for a probe on Maharashtra transfers and postings. Parambir Singh has appealed to the Supreme